The judiciary today held the Chief Justice Benedicto Chiwanuka's 7th memorial lecture at its headquarters in Kampala. The event is held annually in honor of the first Ugandan Chief Justice, Benedicto Chiwanuka, who was deeply committed to the rule of law and human rights. The event began with a procession of justices, judges, registrars and magistrates led by the Chief Justice, Alphonse Chigamoyo Windolo. In his opening remarks, Deputy Chief Justice and Chairperson of the Benedicto Chiwanuka Lecture Organizing Committee, Justice Richard Butera, highlighted that Benedicto Chiwanuka, Uganda's first Chief Justice, was kidnapped and likely murdered in 1972. Butera emphasized the importance of a people-centered approach to justice reflected in the theme of the event. He urged support for these alternative systems, noting their ability to resolve disputes effectively.
The judiciary will continue to hear cases as we have done before. We shall also enhance the use of ADR and AJS at all levels of our courts to promote the people-centered approach to justice.
In his message delivered by the Speaker of Parliament, Anita Among, President Yoweri Museveni lauded Benedicto Chiwanuka for his dedicated service to the country.
Judge Benedicto Chiwanuka was an eminent Ugandan politician who was instrumental in processes leading to Uganda's attainment of independence from the colonialists.
Before his judiciary assignment, Chiwanuka was an eminent politician who was instrumental in the processes leading to Uganda's attainment of its independence from colonialists in October 1962. The Minister for Energy and Mineral Development, Honorable Ruth Nankabirwa, has assured Ugandans that the ministry is doing whatever is possible to stabilize electricity supply across the country. Minister Nankabirwa was launching the construction of Buloba Power Substation in Nachirebe Village in PG District. Her remarks have come at a time when some parts of the country are experiencing regular power cuts, disrupting businesses as well as service delivery.
So people are demanding for power, stable power, affordable power. And I want to assure the assistant RDC that with this intervention, system improvement, we are going to improve the access or to electricity by Ugandans from 60% where we are now to probably 100%, at least by 2030.
During the launch of the construction, the Chief Executive Officer of Uganda Electricity Transmission Company Limited, UETCL, Joshua Karamaji, said that UETCL signed a memorandum of understanding with Japanese companies which include Toyota, China Machinery Engineering Corporation to improve power supply in Kampala and the metropolitan areas.
Installation of new transmission lines and reconductoring of existing transmission lines to improve electricity supply stability and capacity in the region.
The Mpiji RDC Francis Kabuye thanked President Museveni for the development and warned residents against vandalizing the infrastructure. The United States said yesterday that Hezbollah must stop its attacks against Israel if it wants to ease tensions in the region. Hezbollah Chief Hassan Nasrallah, in a speech following the explosion of thousands of communication devices in a stunning assault widely attributed to Israel, vowed to keep fighting Israel until the aggression in Gaza stops. The State Department referred to Nasrallah's remarks when explaining a call by Secretary of State Anthony Blinken against escalatory actions by any party in the Middle East.
We have been made very clear, and you heard the Secretary speak to this publicly yesterday in Egypt, that we don't want to see any party escalate this conflict. We think that the best way to solve the really very real security challenge that Israel faces is through a diplomatic resolution that would allow thousands of Israeli citizens to return home and allow thousands of Lebanese citizens to return home. We're going to continue to press that on all parties.
The statement comes after the leader of Lebanon's Hezbollah announced retaliation for deadly attacks on its communication devices after Israel's defense minister announced a new phase of the war. Hezbollah and the Israeli military traded new strikes over the border yesterday. Fears are increasing that 11 months of exchanges of fire between the two sides will escalate into an all-out war. Lebanon and Hezbollah have blamed Israel for attacks on Hezbollah's communications equipment that killed 37 people and wounded around 3,000, overwhelming Lebanese hospitals and wreaking bloody havoc on the militant group.